Hello class, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. So students, welcome once again to your GK class. I, Achal Singh, welcoming you all once again to your GK class. So students, in our previous session, we have done quiz yourself 2 from the unit number 9, that is mixed bags. Okay, and today I'm going to start with the next topic that is given in your GK book in unit number 9, that is quiz yourself 3. Okay, so this is same as quiz yourself 1 and 2. Okay, now I'm going to start with the third one, that is quiz yourself 3. So here I'm writing the topic, that is quiz yourself 3, and this is given at page number 71. The topic is quiz yourself 3, given at page number 71. So all of you kindly open your books at page number 71, that is quiz yourself 3. Okay, so now here, so certain questions are given and we are going to answer it as usual. Okay, so let's begin with the first one. What is the capital of Egypt? Okay, so you must be aware of the name of the country, that is Egypt. So what is the capital of Egypt? Egypt ki capital kya hai? So the name of the Egypt, so the capital of Egypt is Cairo. So Cairo is the capital of Egypt. So this is the name of a city that is in Egypt. Okay, and this is the biggest city in the Egypt as well. Okay, so the capital of Egypt is Cairo, that is C-A-I-R-O. Capital of Egypt is Cairo. C-A-I-R-O. So this is the capital of Egypt. Cairo is the capital of Egypt. Next one. Who is the author of the 5-point summary and 2 states? So these are the name of the 2 very famous novels. Okay, that is the 5-point summary and 2 states. So you must have watched the movie. Okay, so there are movies also made there on the 2 states. Okay, the 2 states novel hai, uske upar ek movie bhi bani hui hai. Okay, so who is the author of these 2 famous novels? That is Chetan Bhagat. So he is an Indian author. Okay, and his name is Chetan Bhagat. So Chetan Bhagat is the author of the book A 5-point Samvan and the 2 states. Okay, so the answer of the second question, who is the author of 5-point Samvan and 2 states? That is Chetan Bhagat. Okay, Chetan, C-H-E-T-A-N, Chetan Bhagat. Chetan Bhagat is the author of the book 5-point Samvan and 2 states. Okay, so he is also one of the famous author from our India. Okay, so he has written so many novels. Okay, related different topics. So you must have watched the movie 3 Idiots. So that is also based. Okay, the movie 3 Idiots is also based on the one of the novels of Chetan Bhagat. Okay. Next is, which is the longest bone in our body? हमारी बॉडी में विच इज द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन इन अवर ह्यूमन बॉडी. सो एक ह्यूमन बॉडी में सबसे लंबी बोन कौन सी है? दैट इज फीमर. सो फीमर इज द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन इन अवर बॉडी. सो वॉट इज फीमर? फॉर फीमर जिसको हम थाई बोन. ओके, द थाइज हैं. सो दिस इज द बोन दैट इज द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन इन अवर ह्यूमन बॉडी. एक ह्यूमन बॉडी के अंदर विच इज द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी? दैट इज फीमर. दैट वी ऑल्सो कॉल्ड इट एज थाई बोन, जिसको हम थाई बोन भी बोलते हैं. ओके, सो द क्वेश्चन इज विच इज द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन इन आर बॉडी? दैट इज फीमर, एफ ई एम यू आर. फीमर इज द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी. ओके, यू कैन जस्ट राइट इन ब्रैकेट, दैट इज थाई, टी एच आई जी एच, थाई बोन. ओके, इन केस यू फॉरगॉट, यू कैन जस्ट रिवाइज इट हियर. Thigh bone is the longest bone in a human body. Okay, Next, the fourth one.
Which is the largest herbivore on land? Okay. दुनिया में सबसे बड़ा herbivore. Herbivore, देखिए, there are three types of people and the animals. Okay, there are the herbivore, carnivores, and the third is the omnivores. So, what are herbivores? Those animals who feed on only plants. But those who are plant eaters or the grass eaters, they are known as herbivores. Okay, so ऐसे बहुत सारे animals हैं those who only eat grass and plants, leaves. Okay, the plants and the stem खाते हैं, they eat leaves and the grass as their food. Okay, so they are herbivores. जिसको हम if we talk about for the humans, जिसको हम बोलेंगे vegetarian. Okay, so for the humans we use vegetarian, but for the animals we use herbivore. Okay, so the animals, those who fed on only plants and trees and the leaves for their food, they are known as herbivores. The second one is carnivores. So what are carnivores? So carnivore are the animals, those who fed on flesh and meat. Okay, those who eat other animals, okay, as their food. They are known as carnivores. So, जो animals जो कि सिर्फ flesh और meat खाते हैं, okay, जिनका जो खाना है that is only flesh and meat, okay, that is they are carnivores. They are known as the carnivores like cheetah, okay, lion, tiger, and there are many more also, okay. So the example for herbivores, जैसे कि ते herbivores कौन से होते हैं? The herbivores like rabbit, okay, giraffe, and rabbit, ticket, and you can say the goat. So these all are the herbivores animals. Okay, as we have talked about the carnivores, so carnivores are those who just feed on flesh and meat for their food, like tiger. Mostly the wild animals, they are herbivores. Okay, like tiger, leopard, panther. These all are from the cat families. Okay, and third one is omnivores. So what are omnivores? So omnivores are the animals, those who fed on both plants and meat and flesh for their food. Okay, वो animals जो दोनों खाते हैं अपने खाने के लिए for their meal, they can eat and both, as well as the animals, they can eat the other animals, they can eat the plants and the trees as well. So these are known as the omnivores, जो दोनों खाते हैं. Okay, they eat the leaves, they eat the grass, they eat the meat and flesh as well. So these are the omnivores. So the best example for the omnivore animal is the bear. Okay, a bear eats grass or he eats honey and leaves as well, and he can eat even the meat as well. Okay, so bear is a big example of omnivore animal. So वो दोनों खाता है. Okay, so these are the three kinds of the feeders that I have talked about. The first was the omnivore. The first one was the herbivore, second one was the carnivores, and the third one was the omnivores. Now the question here that is given in your book is, which is the largest herbivore on land? Duniya ke upar, dharti ke upar, which is the largest animal? That is the herbivore animal. Though it is the very largest, and that still it is a herbivore animal. That is African elephants. So African elephants hain, they are herbivores. Okay, they only eat the plants, the stems and the leaves, the grass. Okay, so they are the largest animals on the land. Elephant is a largest animal on land, but it is also a herbivore animal. Okay, they only eat grass and the plants and the leaves, okay, as their meal. Okay, so the largest herbivore on land, that is African elephant. So the answer of the fourth one is African elephant. African, African elephant. ENEPHANT. African elephants are the largest herbivore on land. Moving next to the fifth one. The fifth is, according to legend, what are the names of the twins who founded Rome in the 753 BC? Okay, BC is before Christ. Now it is known as BCE, that is before Common Era. Okay, so पहले हम इसको BC बोलते थे, before Christ बोला जाता था. Now it is BCE, but which means before Common Era. Now the question is, according to the legend, what are the names of the twins who founded Rome in the 753 BC? Okay, तो कहते हैं कहावत के अनुसार legends, legends means जो कहते हैं ना पुराने लोग जो बोलते हैं कि that Rome was founded by the two brothers, the twin brothers. So now the question is, उन twin brothers का नाम क्या था? What was the name of those twin brothers? So the name of those twin brothers who founded, who explored the Rome was Romulus and the Remus. Romulus and the Remus, these are the names of the two twins, okay, of the twins. Not two twins, it will be twins only. Twins means two, okay. So you will, we will not say it as two twins, we will say it as the twins only. Okay, so Romulus and the Remus, these are the twins, those who have explored the Rome, jinhone ki Rome ki khoj ki thi, okay. So the answer, the question was, according to the legend, what are the names of the twins who founded Rome in 753 BC? Okay, and this Romulus and the Rome, Romulus, they discovered or they explored the they discovered the Rome in the 753 BC. So the year is also given here. Okay, that is 753 BC. In that time, at that time, the Romulus and the Remus, they invented, sorry, they discovered Rome. So the names of the twins is Romulus and the Remus. Answer of the fifth is Romulus, R-O-M-U-L-U-S. Romulus and Remus, R-E-M-U-S. Romulus and Remus is the name of the twins, those who have discovered, those who have discovered Rome. Okay, moving next to the sixth one. The sixth is given here. Okay, what will you find once in minute, twice in moment, and never in a thousand years? Ashi kaun si, okay, this is kind of a reasoning question. Okay, so before that, just note down all these five answers in your book. Okay, so the first is the Cairo. So Cairo is the capital of Egypt. Second is Chetan Bhagat. So he is one of the famous Indian author. Okay, he has written many novels, and the Two States and the 5-Point Samvat is one some of his famous, the name of one, some of his famous novels. Third is the femur. Femur is the largest bone in a human body, that is a thigh bone. Next is African elephants. So African elephants, it will not be elephant, it will be elephants. So African elephants are termed as the one of the largest herbivore animal on the earth. So duniya mein sabse bade, largest, they are the largest animal, so largest animal on earth, as well as they are the herbivores. So these are the largest herbivore animals on land. Fifth is the Romulus and the Remus. This is the name of the two twins. This is the name of the twins, those who have explored or those who have discovered the Rome. Okay, now moving next to the question number 6. Okay, so the question number 6 is, okay, so the question number 6, it is given, what will you find once in a minute, twice in a moment, and never in a thousand years? ऐसा कौन सी चीज है दैट यू विल फाइंड इन अ मिनट. सो दिस इज काइंड ऑफ अ रीजनिंग क्वेश्चन. सो जस्ट लुक एट द बोर्ड वेरी केयरफुली. दैट इज वंस इन द मिनट. ओके, वंस इन मिनट, ट्वाइस इन, ट्वाइस इन मोमेंट. ओके, एंड द थर्ड इज, द थर्ड वन वॉज दैट नेवर इन थाउजेंड ईयर्स. Never in thousand years. Never in thousands year. So ऐसी कौन सी चीज है that you will find once. Once means एक बार आपको minute में मिलेगी. Two times, twice you will find it in the moment, and you will never find it in the thousand years. उसको thousand years में नहीं मिलेगी. जो आपको एक मिनट में मिल सकती है, दो मोमेंट में मिल सकती है, बट यू विल नॉट फाइंड दैट इन द थाउजेंड ईयर्स. सो दैट इज, व्हाट इज इट, दैट इज लेटर एम. ओके, सो देखिए लेटर एम, देयर इज ओनली वन एम इन मिनट, But there are two M in the word moment, but there is no M. There is no M in this, that is never in thousand years. देखिए दिस इज काइंड ऑफ अ रीजनिंग क्वेश्चन. सो देखिए इसको बहुत ही एक लाइक वी कहते हैं जिसको हम पहेली बोलेंगे. ओके सो व्हाट इज दैट, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन वॉज व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन वॉज व्हाट विल यू फाइंड वंस वंस इन अ मिनट. मिनट में वो एक बार है, दैट इज लेटर एम. तो एम ओनली कम्स वंस इन द मिनट. तो मिनट जब हम लिखते हैं एम ओनली कम्स फॉर द वन टाइम. सेकेंड इज ट्वाइस इन मोमेंट. सो व्हेन यू विल राइट द स्पेलिंग्स ऑफ moment, that is M O M. So that means here the M is coming for the two time, but there is no M in never in the thousand years. Okay, so this line never in the thousand years में कोई भी M नहीं है. Okay, so that is letter M. Letter M. तो so M minute में M एक बार लिखते हैं, moment भी two times लिखते हैं, but never in thousand years में एक बार भी M नहीं आता. So this is just like a पहेली you can say, or this is just like a reasoning question. Okay, so the answer. So sorry, the question was what will you find once in a minute, twice in the moment, and never in thousand years. That is the letter M. The letter M or the alphabetical letter M. You can write anything. Okay, so just write it here. That is the alphabet. Alphabet M. Okay, the letter M. You can alphabet or you can the alphabetical letter. You can just write the letter M. The letter M. Okay. Chali. Moving next to the question number 7. Who was the first woman Prime Minister of India? इंडिया की सबसे पहली वुमेन प्राइम मिनिस्टर कौन थी? सबसे पहली इंडिया की सॉरी प्राइम मिनिस्टर इंडिया के प्राइम मिनिस्टर बनने वाली सबसे पहली वुमेन, वुमेन्स मीन लेडी. सो हु वाज द फर्स्ट वुमेन टू बिकेम द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया? दैट इज इंदिरा गांधी. सो इंदिरा गांधी बिकेम द फर्स्ट वुमेन प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया. ओके सो नाउ हु वाज द फर्स्ट वुमेन प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया? तो इंडिया की सबसे पहली वुमेन प्रेसिडेंट कौन थी? दैट वॉज प्रतिभा पाटिल. प्रतिभा पाटिल वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन प्रेजिडेंट एंड इंदिरा गांधी वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया. ओके सो जस्ट कीप दीज टू नेम्स इन योर माइंड दैट प्रतिभा पाटिल वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन प्रेजिडेंट प्रेजिडेंट ऑफ अवर इंडिया एंड इंदिरा गांधी वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इंडिया. द क्वेश्चन वॉज अबाउट प्राइम मिनिस्टर, दैट इज हु वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन Prime Minister of India, that is Indira Gandhi. That is Indira Gandhi. Answer of the seventh is Indira Gandhi. I-N-D-R-A. Indira Gandhi. So Indira Gandhi was the first woman Prime Minister of India. सबसे पहली महिला थी जो कि हमारे भारत की प्रधानमंत्री बनी थी. ओके चलिए नेक्स्ट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. विच ऑफ दीज फॉर्म्स ऑफ डांस इज पंडित बिरजू महाराज एसोसिएटेड विद? ओके सो हियर द नेम ऑफ थ्री डांस फॉर्म्स इज गिवन. द फर्स्ट वन इज द भरतनाट्यम, सेकंड इज द कुचिपुड़ी एंड द थर्ड इज द कथक. सो दीज आर द नेम्स ऑफ द थ्री डांस फॉर्म. ओके क्लासिकल डांस फॉर्म, दीज ऑल दीज थ्री आर द क्लासिकल डांस फॉर्म ऑफ इंडिया. The first one is the Bharatanatyam, second is the Kuchipudi and the third is the Kathak. So, ye tino India ke classical dance form hai. Now, the question is, which of these forms of dance is Pandit Birju Maharaj associated with? Jo Pandit Birju Maharaj hai, wo in tino mein se kaun si dance form ke saath associated hai? Okay, so that is Kathak. So, Pandit Birju Maharaj was associated with is associated with Kathak dance form. Kathak is also the folk dance of your state, that is Uttar Pradesh. So, Uttar Pradesh ka jo dance form hai, okay, what we call it, famous folk dance hai. So, what is the folk dance of Uttar Pradesh? That is Kathak. So, Kathak is the dance form of a folk dance of Uttar Pradesh, and this with this Pandit Birju Maharaj, he is a famous Kathak dancer. Okay, so Pandit Birju Maharaj is associated with Kathak. So the answer of the 8th one is Kathak. K-A-T-H-A-K. Pandit Birju Maharaj is associated with the famous folk dance of Uttar Pradesh, or the famous form of dance, that is Kathak. K-A-T-H-A-K. Okay, moving next. In which city would you find the famous building Burj Khalifa? कौन सी सिटी में आपको जो फेमस बिल्डिंग बुर्ज खलीफा, यू कैन, इट इज लोकेटेड देयर, दैट इज इन दुबई. दैट इज, दुबई इज इन यूएई, यूनाइटेड अरब एमिरेट्स. दिस इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ यूएई. ओके, सो दुबई इज द नेम ऑफ अ सिटी दैट इज, एंड दैट कम्स इन यूएई. यूएई इज द नेम ऑफ द, दिस इज यूएई इज द नेम ऑफ द, यू कैन सी दिस इज काइंड ऑफ अ कंट्री जिसमें के अंदर की छोटी छोटी सिटी लाइक दुबई, अबू धाबी, शाहजहां, सो ऑल दिस सिटीज कम अंडर द यूएई. वो यूएई के अंडर आते हैं. ओके, सो देर आर 7 डिफरेंट सिटीज दैट कम अंडर यूएई. ओके, यू कैन सी सिटी और यू कैन सी द स्टेट एज वेल. ओके, सो दीज आर द नेम फेमस 7 स्टेट्स ऑफ यूएई. ओके, सो उसके अंडर ही दुबई इज इज वन ऑफ द फेमस सिटी ऑफ यूएई. ओके, एंड देयर द फेमस बिल्डिंग विच इज द लार्जेस्ट man-made or human-made structure in the world, not the largest, the highest. So the highest human-made structure in the world is Burj Khalifa. Jo Burj Khalifa hai, jo ki Dubai mein hai, that is the highest, or you can tell the tallest. Okay, that is the tallest man-made structure in the world. Okay, and its height is near about 668 meters. So this is the highest. No, sorry, 875 meters. It is 800 something. This is not 600. This is near about 800 and something, 75 or 72 meter high. This is the height of that Burj Khalifa. Okay, and there are near about 108 stories or 123. So one, I think there is 123. Okay, stories in that Burj Khalifa, and this is, that's why it is known as one of the tallest. Sorry, this is the highest, not one of the. This is the highest man-made structure in the world. Okay, so I will just tell you exact about it. So the height of Burj Khalifa is 828 meter. Okay, and this is the tallest structure ever built by humans. Okay, and there are 163 stories in Burj Khalifa. Okay, and that look. Okay, so जो Burj Khalifa की जो वो बना हुआ है, जो structure है, that is made by the inspiration from a desert flower. So desert जो यू नो यूएई जो दुबई है वो एक डेजर्ट एरिया है, तो वहां पे जो बुर्ज खलीफा की जो बिल्डिंग है, जो उसकी स्ट्रक्चर है, दैट इज बीइंग इंस्पायर्ड बाय फ्रॉम वन ऑफ द डेजर्ट फ्लावर दैट इज हिम्नोकालिस. हिम्नोकालिस, ओके, सो जो हिम्नोकालिस है, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ अ डेजर्ट फ्लावर जो कि डेजर्ट्स में उगता है. ओके, उसी के लुक से और उसी के स्ट्रक्चर से इंस्पायर होगी जो बुर्ज खलीफा का जो स्ट्रक्चर है बना है. एंड बुर्ज खलीफा इज वन ऑफ द हाईएस्ट, is the tallest, not the highest, it is the tallest structure made by the humans, and the height of this Burj Khalifa is 828 meter, and there are 163 stories, 163 jo manzile hain uske andar, can be stories matlab manzile. Okay, there are 163 stories in this Burj Khalifa, and this is built on the design of that Burj Khalifa is being inspired from one of the desert flower, which is, whose name is Hymnocalis. Okay, so the question was in which city would you find the famous building Burj Khalifa, that is Dubai. So the answer of the 9th one is Dubai. D-U-B-A-I. Dubai. Moving next to the 10th one. The 10th is, who is the writer of the national anthem of Bangladesh? Okay, so who is the writer of the national anthem of Bangladesh? Bangladesh ka national anthem kisne likha hai? So the writer of the national anthem of the Bangladesh is Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, dekhiye, the Rabindranath Tagore is the writer of both the national anthem of India as well as of Bangladesh. So unhone India aur Bangladesh dono countries ka national anthem likha hai. Okay, So the name of the what was the national anthem of Bangladesh? That is Amar Sonar Bangla. This is the national anthem of Bangladesh, and Jan Gan Man is the national anthem of our country India. And these two national anthem are written by Rabindranath Tagore, and Rabindranath Tagore is the first Asian also who has won the Nobel Prize. Okay, वो एशिया पूरी एशिया में सबसे पहले Nobel Prize जीतने वाले सबसे पहले person थे. Okay, so who write the national anthem of Bangladesh? That is Rabindranath Tagore. That is the answer of the 10th one. That is Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore. Okay, so these are the answers from 6 to 10. Okay. Now moving next to question number 11. The question number 11 is, what is Chrome a type of? Browser, social networking site or instant messenger? Okay, jo Chrome hai. Okay, so this Chrome, so must have heard about the Google Chrome. To wo kya hai? What is that? Is that a type of a browser? Kya wo ek browser hai? जो हम नेट सर्फिंग के लिए यूज करते हैं. सेकेंड इज, दिस इज द सोशल नेटवर्किंग साइट, और इज इट अ नेम ऑफ अ सोशल नेटवर्किंग साइट लाइक फेसबुक, और इट्स एन इंस्टेंट मैसेंजर लाइक व्हाट्सएप मैसेंजर. सो व्हाट इज इट? सो क्रोम इज अ ब्राउजर. ओके, सो व्हेनेवर यू वांट टू सर्च एनीथिंग, व्हेनेवर यू वांट टू ब्राउज एनीथिंग, सर्च करना हो, सो यू यूज दिस क्रोम. ओके, दैट इज अ नेम ऑफ अ ब्राउजर. ओके, सो द डिफॉल्ट नेम इज द गूगल क्रोम. Okay, so what is Chrome a type of? Browser, social networking site or instant messenger? That is a type of a browser. So answer of the 11th one is browser. B-R-O-Z-E-R. B-R-O-W-S-E-R. Browser. 12th one. In the epic, the Mahabharat, who was the eldest brother of the Pandavas? जो महाभारत है उसमें जो पांडव के सबसे बड़े भाई का नाम क्या था? What was the name of the eldest brother of Pandavas? Okay, so there are five Pandavas are the five brothers. Okay, Yudhishthir, Bhim, Arjun, Nakul and Sahadev. So these are the names of the five Pandavas. So who was the eldest? सबसे बड़े कौन थे? That was Yudhishthir. So Yudhishthir was the eldest brother among the Pandavas. Or the Pandavas, you can see. So the answer of the 12th one is Yudhishthir. Y-U-T-H-I-S-S-H-T-R-A. Yudhishthir. Yes, Yudhishthir. So Yudhishthir, just me like this, check the spelling. Okay, Y-U-D-I-S-D-H-I-S-H-T-H-I-R. Yudhishthir was the eldest brother of Pandavas. Clear? Moving next to the 13th one. With which state of India is the folk dance Bihu associated? तो Bihu India के कौन से state का famous folk dance है? So Bihu is the famous folk dance of Assam. So Bihu is the famous folk dance of Assam. A-S-S-A-M. So Bihu is the famous folk dance of Assam. Moving to the 14th. Okay, which Bollywood actress played the lead role in the US television series Quantico? So, कौन सी इंडिया की जो एक्ट्रेस थी, बॉलीवुड की एक्ट्रेस थी, जिन्होंने की एक यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स के फेमस टेलीविजन सीरीज Quantico में एक लीड रोल प्ले किया था? So, that she was Priyanka Chopra. She was Priyanka Chopra. Okay, the last is, what is the capital of Saudi Arabia? So, what is the capital of Saudi Arabia? So, the capital of Saudi Arabia is Riyadh. So, Riyadh is the capital of Saudi Arabia. Riyadh is the capital of Saudi Arabia. Okay, so these are the answers from 11 to 15. 11th is Browser, 12th is Yudhishthir, 13th is Assam, 14th is Priyanka Chopra, and the 15th is Riya. Okay, so this was our today's session class. So with this, I'm just ending the session here only. So I'll see you again very soon in our next session. So till then, everybody, have a good day.